Well, our musical guest this week is the supremely talented Whitney Monger. Hello, girl.
Hello.
Hello. And who's this wonderful talent right here?
This is Skylar Mihal.
Skylar, it's so good to have you on the show, too. Well, you're quite the phenom. You have a lot of fans here in this room, actually. And you cut your teeth musically busking at the Pike Place Market.
That's right.
Would that be true? What did you learn about performing by playing on the street like that?
Don't be afraid. Yeah, you can't really be afraid out there. Mm-hmm. It's not for the weak of heart.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Taught me to sing a little bit more loudly, more raw.
Yeah.
Gave me some of my chops on my guitar.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Did you make money?
Yeah, I did it for about 10 years.
I'd
like to think I was able to pay my rent time because of it.
I love what Jake Udy, KEXP, he describes your sound this way. Whitney Monger's voice cracks, crumbles, aches, and breaks your heart. It's one made of 100-year-old salvaged Northwest wood, complete with embossed grains, nicks, and honest imperfections. That's a fabulous paragraph. Does that resonate for you, a 100-year-old salvaged piece of Northwest timber?
Yeah, people like that. Yeah. That was a really cool write-up.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, I felt like I was received well.
Mm-hmm. He kind of got you.
Yeah.
Yeah. You put out 4 records since 2011. Let's see, Heartbeat, Steadfast, mm-hmm. Stone, and then last year, in 2018, it was Carry On.
Correct.
Right?
Yeah.
Has your songwriting evolved or changed over that chunk of time?
Yes and no. I feel like I've always been the kind of songwriter that attacks music in a way of how do other people write music. I love music. I listen to a lot of music, even more so than I play it, which is a lot.
Mm-hmm.
So I take from a lot of my favorite artists and even local artists and kind of use that as a way to write my songs. I would say I've gotten a little more efficient as far as writing. I'm a little more intentional about my songs and less like about I need to feel this pain or ache in order to create something. Yeah,
right.
I'm becoming more of a writer that really just, this is what I want to write about and just get into it and
just
write about it.
Dig.
Yeah.
Is it lyric usually that starts it or is it a melody or different?
It's typically a melody, but you know, I have a lot of books of songs that have never really met a melody, so I don't know, maybe there's a song for those, but most of the time it's a melody that kind of pulls in a story for me.
Yeah. Well, we're so pleased that you're here, you too, Skylar, and so you're going to play us a couple songs off of Carry On, and I believe first up is Be Mine?
Yes.
Is that right?
Yeah.
All right, are you ready to do this thing?
Let's do it.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, Whitney Monger and Skylar Mihal.
1, 2, 3, and all right, yeah.
Do you want to get high? Do you want to get low? Do you want some to fill that hole? You're looking for loving, but I got you. You're looking for something to do. You can't call up. Baby, yeah, just about any time. So baby, you'll say that you'll be mine. I got sugar in my body, I got sugar in my soul. But the first I ever saw you was the first I ever known that it was love. Oh, yes, it was. Know it's true, can't stop thinking about you. You can't call upon me, baby, yeah, just about any time. So baby, you'll say that you'll be mine. Talk to me now. To the core. Tonight is the night I say what I never said before. I think I love you. I think I do. I think I love you. I think I love you. I think I do. I think I love you. I think I love you. I think I do. I think I'm so, so, so in love with you. I think I love you. I think I do. I think I'm so, so, so in love with you. Wow! And oh yeah, and alright. And oh yeah, 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 yeah. Do you wanna get high? Or do you wanna get low? Do you want so, so, so to fit that hole? You're looking for loving, well I got you. Maybe you'll say that you'll be mine. All right. Thank you.